After a long wait of nearly 9 months, college football returns here on a sun-splashed Saturday afternoon in beautiful Bloomington, Indiana, where today it's the Hoosiers squaring off against Southern Illinois, all a part of Dick's Sporting Goods kickoff week. And hi, everybody. Glad you could join us alongside of two-time Super Bowl champion David Diaz Infante. I am Roy Philpott. And David, optimism runs rampant this time of year. No losses, no injuries. And here at IU, they get their starting quarterback back in Nate Sudfeld.
They say if you got a quarterback, you got a chance. And in Indiana, they have a quarterback in Nate Sudfeld. He's 6'6". He's got a cannon arm with a quick release, making only his 15th start. He's a guy that can get it done from it. He's a leader. He's approached this season with a new sense of urgency and confidence. Working with these young wide receivers, he knows as he goes, this Indiana football team will go.
Well, SIU going to try to spring an upset this afternoon, just like it did 9 years ago. If it's going to happen, it's their quarterback, Mark Iannotti, a senior against a very young IU secondary.
Yeah, Mark Iannotti is a guy, a transfer from Eastern Michigan. Again, was benched for 3 games last year and really grew up from that experience and handled it well and realized what it takes to be a starting quarterback at this level. He's a quarterback that plays it with a linebacker mentality, and they're going to need that if they're going to pull off an upset here at Indiana.
Nobody's going to question his toughness and certainly going to try to pull off that upset this afternoon. IU won the opening coin toss and deferred. It'll be the Salukis of Southern Illinois to receive the football first. Glad you could join us. An energized crowd here in Bloomington, inside of Memorial Stadium. Daquan Isom back deep to receive this IU kick. Hoosiers 4-8 a season ago, trying to bounce back in year number 5 of the Kevin Wilson era. Eric Toke. Set to kick it away. And an early flag. Well, an ominous beginning.
Delay game. Kicking team. 5-yard penalty. Free kick.
Well, these two schools separated by just 236 miles. Second all-time meeting, SIU defeated Indiana back in 2006 in the first ever victory for the Missouri Valley Football Conference over the Big Ten. Trying to repeat history here today.
Well, we talked about opening weekend. There's a lot of things that can happen, and penalties are a part of that. Special teams always a big factor early in the season. Young players out on the field and turnovers.
And it'll be Griffin Oaks kicking off. And we are underway in Bloomington. Isom's got to hurry inside his own 5. And pushes his way across the 20. It'll be 1st and 10 for the Salukis. Stop made by Damian Willis Jr. Mark Iannotti, our first chance to look at the 6'2", 220-pound senior out of Schaumburg, Illinois. Transferred in from Eastern Michigan, David. I know you've been really impressed with his film.
Yeah, tell you what, they give him a lot of responsibility at the line of scrimmage in terms of checking from a run play to a pass play, the protection schemes, and he's a guy that's really grown up this offseason.
Just 4 starters back on this SIU offense. A unit that averaged 29 points per game a season ago. And the handoff straight up the gut with room to run, and there he goes, Cameron Walter. Into Indiana territory. Gain of 29 yards.
Head coach Dale Lennon talked about his football team and felt their offensive line was one of the strengths, physical up front, and they've got a couple of running backs that are short in stature, but quick as heck.
Walter, the only running back on the roster with a carry at SIU. The end around to Limprakis. Another positive gain on first down.
Number 1, Israel
Limprakis. A 7-yard gain, it'll bring up 2nd and short. Now, Indiana defensively without several key players. We'll tell you about that in just a few minutes. It was announced just moments before kickoff. As Feeney goes in motion. On 2nd down, caught, and that's good enough for the 1st down. Iwema makes a reception. And we mentioned the players that have been deemed ineligible. They will not play today because, quote, they did not live up to the responsibilities to the program. You take a look at that list, Dave. Tigray Scales, one of the top tacklers from a season ago, plus two defensive tackles in that front three. Major losses here for Indiana. The Somer in at quarterback, right side, and another pickup on first down. And make that Aaron Stanton with the carry.
And you'll see Matt DeSomer, he's a guy that's a, he's the X factor for them offensively. Coming at the quarterback position, he'll be the wildcat. He makes things happen. They're trying to get him 12 to 15 touches a game.
Officially on the roster as a signal caller, but he can do a number of different things for SIU. And Nadi with time, looking deep, and overshoots his intended target, Jimmy Jones. Well, Dave, your impact players, T.J. Simmons, for this Indiana defense, needs to step up, and he could do it right now.
Well, T.J. Simmons is a thumper in the middle for Indiana. They're a 3-4 defense, apply a lot of pressure. And then you got Matt DeSomer, and he's a guy, like we said, he's the X factor on offense. They're going to get him the ball in a lot of ways. You got to be careful when he is in the field, on the field, and where he's lined up.
SIU 48% on third down a season ago. Play action and nothing doing. The pressure applied by Heffron, and that'll force the incompletion. And now decision time for Southern Illinois and Dale Lennon.
You'll see Mark Iannotti again, unblocked, blitzing linebacker, defensive lineman. It's defensive tackle Sean Heffron coming free up the middle. Again, it threw up the timing off the timing of that screen. But smart play by Iannotti of throwing the ball away, burn it, so they can stay in field goal position.
So the drive bogs down. It'll be a 49-yard field goal attempt off the foot of Austin Johnson. And a timeout called by the Salukis. Well, a very impressive opening drive, Dave. And you felt as if SIU would have some quality play up front. They're showing it so far.
I tell you what, I was impressed with them. They're a physical, scrappy football team. When I turned on that Purdue video from last year, they're physical up front, and I think with the maturation process that their quarterback's gone through, they do enough things offensively. They give you some problems. If you have a guy with the ball in his hands and knows where to go with it, that's the difference between a good offense and a great offense.
Dale Lennon said earlier in preseason camp, right now his team was a bunch of nobodies trying to find some playmakers, and that's going to be one of the keys this afternoon for the Salukis to spring the upset. And of course, Kevin Wilson, year number five here in Bloomington. 14-34 career mark. This could be his most talented team yet. They've got to find a way to win some more games.
Well, I think they've done a good job recruiting. The talent level and the depth has increased in this football team. But you'll see, he's holding guys accountable too. That's why those young men are sitting out this afternoon.
This would be a career long for Johnson. And he comes up short. That may have been tipped at the line of scrimmage. Jonathan Crawford penetrating the line. And the opening drive for the Salukis results in no points.
We talked about special teams are a big factor early in the season, especially opening weekend. And again, it shows right there. It looks like that kick may have been a little low. Some pressure right up the middle by Indiana. You can see the jump and the block. Boy, that's just great vertical, getting up and putting those paws in the way.
6'2".
Nice job on special teams.
190-pound freshman Jonathan Crawford. Very high on his potential this season here at IU. And now our first look at Nate Sudfeld. Injured last season in the second quarter against Iowa. It's an injury to his non-throwing shoulder. Hoosiers open up in a four wide receiver set. On first down with a zone read, the first carry for Jordan Howard, the transfer from UAB. And bullies his way ahead for 4 yards. You see the numbers for Nate Sudfeld. Second in program history in completion percentage. Tied for second in 300-yard passing games. This guy can do it all. And again, Howard left side with daylight, crossing the 50 and into SIU territory. It'll be first and 10 for Indiana. A pickup of 20 yards.
Jordan Howard's a guy that had over 1,500 yards rushing last year at UAB. He's physical, he's fast, and he fits the system extremely well.
You see the numbers, fourth most football bowl subdivision. Sudfeld to the air. Pass is caught. Mitchell Page with the reception. And of course, Jordan Howard, Dave, one of our impact players, and rightfully so.
Yeah, Jordan Howard, he's 240 pounds. He's fast. He can break the long one. He's physical, which is really a big plus in this offense.
Page on the tunnel screen, shoved out of bounds inside the 20-yard line. Indiana going tempo and finding success.
Well, it'll be up to Chase Allen. That Southern Illinois defense is very aggressive. They apply a lot of pressure. They take some chances. They have to know. They have to be able to stop Jordan Howard first. If they get let him get going, Indiana's going to be awfully hard to stop.
After the 16-yard pickup, first and 10. Talk to coaches all the time. Very difficult to simulate the pace of an up-tempo, fast-break offense. SIU having to adjust on the fly as Howard dives straight ahead, a gain of four. And the tackle made by DJ Cameron.
Nothing fancy there, just north and south running. Good job of the offensive line. This offensive line is one of the best in the Big Ten. They're big, they're physical, and they have a lot of starts underneath their belts.
Two players in preseason camp putting up 500 pounds on the bench press, and the entire line over 400 pounds on the bench press. I know those are your kind
my
of numbers.
My kind of guys, yeah.
Play action, left side and upended, but after a pickup of three. And the tackle made by Jefferson Villa.
And you see early on, Nate Sudfeld has a cannon for an arm. And a quick release. That ball gets there in a hurry, and his ball placement is excellent. The ball, those throws are a lot harder than they seem because you got to hit that wide receiver or that running back in stride to gain positive yards.
Andre Booker with the reception, a big third down coming up. Just underway here in Bloomington. Man-to-man coverage, bottom of your screen. Instead, it goes the other way. End zone, touchdown, IU, Divine Reddy. Sophomore from Youngstown, Ohio, with the honors to begin this 2015 campaign.
You'll see the left side line, just a little pin and pull scheme. Both guys blocking on the second level, creating an alley for Divine Reddy to go practically untouched into the end zone.
His sixth career touchdown, and the Hoosiers strike first. The extra point is up. It is good. And with 9:47 remaining in our first quarter, our new score, Indiana 7, SIU nothing.
Every season starts at Dick's. ESPN College Football.
If you do add 2010, their vows include a reference to IU basketball. most importantly, they believe
ESPN College Football, brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
Back in Bloomington, 7-0 our score, just underway. Indiana and Southern Illinois, 9:47 remaining in our first quarter. David Diaz, Infante, Roy Philpott. IU without three key defensive players today. And also of note, we did not see Chase Dutra on the field in that first defensive sequence. So maybe as many as four different Indiana defenders. He's so far unavailable. That's costly.
Well, this is a defense that they've been making strides, improved a lot last year. Now in the second season of Brian Knorr, they're expected to take another step forward. And you need all your guys on the field.
Isom kneels down in the end zone. First and 10 for SIU from its 25. Southern Illinois went 47 yards on its opening possession. 49-yard field goal attempt off the foot of Austin Johnson was rejected. And now a critical second drive. Matt DeSomer back in at quarterback, operating in the Wildcat package. And his first career game for the Salukis. Five-man front shown by the Hoosiers. End around. Well, he made something out of nothing. That was Jimmy Jones on the carry. A gain of 5 yards.
You're right. Jimmy Jones did a nice job of putting the brakes on, heading north and south as the defense was slightly over pursued because contain was there. They had the force up the field. He just made a nice job of finding a soft spot and putting his head down.
SIU 6-6 last season. Very difficult schedule in the FCS ranks. Talking with Dale Lennon this week, he feels like they can be much improved this year, and they've got to find some playmakers. Iannotti, well, he's showing you the grit and the toughness. Close to first down yardage on the quarterback keeper.
Yeah, the quarterback run game is a design part of this offense. When you have a quarterback like Iannotti, that's physical and tough. They're not afraid to use him. He's just going to follow the pulling guard right there. Quarterback power off the fly sweep. Good blocking at the point of attack. Quarterback puts his shoulders down and goes north and south.
You got to respect that as a former O lineman. And there he goes again. Right side, nothing doing. Stacked up at the line. All he needed was about 2 inches, and it looks like he got about 3.5. Salukis convert their first third down opportunity in two tries.
Talking about Mark Iannotti and how much he learned from being benched last year for 3 games, about what it takes to be a starting quarterback, how much study and preparation goes in it to really be prepared, and how much people are counting on you and watching what you do and how you do it.
Always critical at the quarterback position. Another end-around play. Iwema with the carry. And T.J. Simmons the stop. So early on, Dave, we see Southern Illinois trying to get to the edge with some of their wide receivers.
Well, you see them, a lot of guys touching the football, very multiple in their attack. Under center from gun.
After a pickup of 2 yards, here's play action. Iannotti with all kinds of time. And he'll dump it down to his running back, Aaron Stanton. Junior college transfer. Was a player of the year in his conference last season. Out of California.
I tell you, a smart player by Iannotti right there. Again, they want to take a shot down the field to Iwema, but he was covered, and then what he did, he hit his check down. He's looking downfield. It's not there. He comes back to the guy that's open into the flat area, and they got a manageable third down.
More misdirection. That's Stanton right up the gut, and he crosses the 50-yard line into Hoosiers territory for another SIU first down. The stop made by A.J. Rayner.
Aaron Stanton is a junior college transfer. He's only 5 foot five, but he's 180, 190 pounds. So the guy's a little stronger than you think for such a shortened stature, but he is quick as heck.
Ainati again. Close to the 45. Gain of four on first down. Stanton averaged 9 yards per carry in spring practice, as told to us by Dale Lennon earlier this week. So yeah, he's got some toughness and some jets.
Yeah, low center, gravity, quickness, and he, you hide behind those offensive linemen, those defenders. Hard for linebackers to pick him up.
And here's the throwback to DeSomer. Thought about it, tries to get to the edge, and sandwiched out of bounds. Zach Shaw with the tackle.
You see Matt DeSomer. Remember, he was trained as a quarterback in this offense, so he's got some football IQ. Look, it's not there. He tucks it and runs for positive yards. Those are the things that keep your offense on track and in rhythm. And you'll see they're spreading this football around. There's a lot of different touches going on, a lot of different design.
Under six to play in the first quarter. Ainati had some running room, instead dumps it off, and that'll be another first down. A catch by Darrell James, his first of the season, and a tackle by Andre Brown. Pickup of 11 yards, and here comes tempo for SIU. And a timeout called by Indiana. First time out of the contest called for the Hoosiers.
And this is even Indiana that's used to running up-tempo offense. I mean, that's Kevin Wilson. That's his background. That's what they want to do, you know.
Timeout on the field. We'll take one with them. 7-0, Indiana. Well, the playoff push begins tonight as number 20 Wisconsin takes on third-ranked Alabama back here in Bloomington after the timeout. I want to make sure that you're watching this evening at 8 o'clock on ABC and stream live at home and on the go. Watch ESPN.com. Nick Saban, who will he start at quarterback? One of five different options. Everybody wants to know.
What a mystery. Paul Chris back at Wisconsin, his alma mater.
10th play of the drive, back to live action, and again it's Mark Ainati. Right up the gut, Nick Mangieri with the stop after a pickup of four.
Certainly with the amount of players not suiting up, you'd think that the Indiana defensive depth might be tested on these long drives right now in this heat.
Yeah, record heat here in the Bloomington area over the Labor Day weekend. As hot as it's been in the last two decades. 92 degrees at kickoff. And left side still on his feet all the way down inside the red zone. Jonathan Mixon with the carry. After a pickup of 13 yards, Mixon not even mentioned us this week by the coaching staff, a bit of an unknown.
They're just pulling guys off the bench right now. I tell you, you could do that when your offensive line is veteran and physical up front. Right now, they're controlling line of scrimmage.
After the first down pickup, down inside the 15. And SIU so far, Dave, with nearly 100 yards of total offense here in our first quarter. Tackle made by Marcus Oliver. Second down and 8 coming up, and Mark Iannotti has looked very sharp, looking like a senior so far.
Looking like a guy that's done his homework.
Play action fake into the end zone and incomplete. Limprakis was breaking wide open, the coverage by Rashard Fant.
I love the play call, play action. Iannotti off the fake, knows he's got Limprakis. Over the middle, just hit a little too much on that ball. He kept it thin, just led the receiver a tad much. He was there, open, missed an opportunity there. That's one he's going to want back.
And completed 63% of his passes a year ago. Should have made that one right there. Third down. Under pressure. And the dump off pass down to the 10-yard line. 3 yards short of first down yardage. And Billy Reed with the reception. And the field goal unit back on the field for SIU.
Look, Indiana's going to bring pressure right up the middle. Linebacker's going to come free. Iannotti's going to take a hit and deliver a strike just short of the first down. But again, puts them in much better field goal position. They got to come away with points.
Johnson had his last kick blocked from 49, 7 of 12 from the field goal department last season. This one from 27 yards out, and he splits the uprights. 3:25 remaining in our first quarter. SIU on the scoreboard, 7-3 here in Bloomington.
Before today's game, the most loyal IU football fans received free face painting in Hoosier Village. No matter where you are in the world or what surfaces you're coating, Sherwin-Williams provides innovative solutions that ensure your success. Sherwin-Williams, a proud sponsor of IU football.
After the 15-play, 65-yard drive, Dell Lennon's Salukis on the scoreboard. 3:25 remaining first quarter action back here in Bloomington. David Diaz-Infante, Roy Philpott here with you. Entertaining start to this one, kind of what we expected.
Yeah, I tell you what, you know, when we turned on the film and saw SIU, we knew that they were a physical team, and so did Kevin Wilson in Indiana. They had a lot of respect on, hey, these guys are scrappy. And so they just put together a 15-yard drive. The IU defense was able to hold them to a field goal, but this is going to be a football game.
Chris Adams set to kick things away. You got to believe, too, SIU playing in the Missouri Valley Football Conference, FCS level. That helps condition this program for these kinds of opponents. And yeah. Tackle to the 15.
They are physical and tough. They're used to banging.
Well, the Hoosiers and their scoring drive. Devine Redding from 13 yards out. Ground game in motion here.
Yeah, 7 plays, 68 yards. And you see Jordan Howard right there again. They're physical, spread the ball around as well. Good job by the offensive line. Kevin Wilson believes in being balanced offensive. They want to be able to run the football. And there's Devine Redding taking in from 13 yards out for the touchdown.
Nate Sudfeld's numbers perfect so far. And that rocket arm on display. And the Hoosiers backed up deep in their own territory. Howard zone read, and he plows his way ahead. A gain of 4 on first down. A tackle made by Chase Allen. First time today we've called his name.
Chase Allen, the outstanding middle linebacker. He's a guy that the coaches feel like could play anywhere. He's got great speed, one of the better athletes on the team. So he goes sideline to sideline from that middle linebacker position.
And defensive coordinator David Ellison telling us he runs as well as any player on the roster at SIU. Very excited when we ask him about his star inside backer. On second down, Howard. Now Jordan Howard going to do his very best to try to impersonate Tevin Coleman from last season, who rushed for over 2,000 yards and was a high-round draft pick by the Atlanta Falcons. Not going to be easy, but certainly he's got some numbers that are impressive.
Yeah, what a pleasant surprise to transfer in from UAB. And he's a guy, you know, he had over 300 carries last season. He's a workhorse. He's used to carrying the load. So we'll see how many carries, opportunities he gets here this afternoon.
Yeah, ranked second nationally among active running backs in career carries. And a late flag, that'll be a false start against IU.
False start. Offense, number 67. 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
Those are the kind of things that'll drive a coach crazy. One, it's a non-competitive penalty. And two, it's on third down. Those are two big no-nos right there. And that's by one of the veteran offensive linemen up front, Dan Feeney. He's a bell cow. He's a physical, tough guy. And this offensive line, they're out to make a statement. They're one of the best in the Big Ten, and they've got some pedigree to them.
Experience, size, outstanding footwork at the edge. And instead of third and three, it's now third down and long. Sudfeld with time tries to thread the needle and nearly picked off. My DJ Cameron came crashing in, the redshirt senior, making his 35th consecutive start. And that should have been a pick six.
Yeah, great protection by the offensive line, but Nate Sudfeld, one thing happens when you got a cannon for an arm. Sometimes you think you squeeze in when most people can't. Look, he's staring down his wide receiver, and you see DJ Cameron make a great break on the football and disrupt that third down conversion.
And Simi Cobbs did a nice job playing cornerback that time, the wide receiver for the Hoosiers.
Yeah, became a defender, right?
Yeah, could have been disaster, and it is with the block punt. Crashing in was Chase Allen. And into the end zone for the SIU touchdown. Boy, special teams can be the equalizer. And the Salukis out in front for the first time.
You can see him come right off the edge. He gets a clean block, takes it right off the punter's foot. And boy, look at the bounce this ball takes. In the end zone to stay, go from going out of the back of the end zone, stays in for the touchdown for SIU. We talked about special teams and what a factor they are early on in the season, especially opening weekend.
Kenny James with the fumble recovery. And if a team like Southern Illinois is going to pull off the upset, And the fake on the two-point conversion attempt. Well, we've seen a little bit of everything, and it's good. Iannotti, the holder, snuck in there.
You wonder how the holder completed a ball like that. I mean, he looked comfortable and out to the edge. You'll see him, he picks it up. It's a fake all the way. Watch him roll out, and this is a starting quarterback in there throwing a strike for the two-point conversion.
Well, the riverboat gambler, we're seeing it in effect. Dale Lennon rolling the dice. And SIU with an 11-7 lead. Chase Allen with a block punt, and he just had an open path right to the punter.
See Chase Allen, we talked about his speed. He comes clean right off the edge of the wall. And again, he covers that. He had that blocked all the way. It went right into the midsection of his body. And there was Kenny James to pick it up for six.
And we asked Chase Allen, where does that speed and athleticism come from? He played all kinds of different sports growing up. Paid dividends right there. 6'3", 240-pound junior. And this crowd here at Memorial Stadium shocked by what they just witnessed. Crossing the 30-yard line after the kickoff. It'll be first and 10 for the Hoosiers. Williams with the return. James, who just scored the touchdown, with the tackle.
You know, the way things have gone here in this first quarter, this SIU football team has got some confidence right now. They got a little juice going.
Finlatter with the two-point play. Off the fake from Mark Iannotti. Let's see if Sudfeld can try to settle things down. Redding in the backfield, zone read. Quality pickup on first down, it'll bring up second down and five.
34 Redding on the near.
Golden with the tackle, and Dave, you can sense the lack of energy all of a sudden here in Bloomington. Redding will try to change that. Gets to the edge. Flag on the field. And finally tackled out of bounds by Adam Brandt. And in the neighborhood of holding, this one likely coming back.
Holding. Offense. Number 84. 10-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
And you'll see the tight end, Danny Friend. You know, they had caught SIU off ground. You see the tight end right there, left center of your screen. Again, just tugging that jersey on the perimeter. They're going to call that every time. When they see the defender go down, boy, that tells them to throw the flag.
And Kevin Wilson can't believe it. That negates a 34-yard run.
And they had caught, their tempo had caught in that SIU defense, not even down in their stances yet.
Approaching a minute to play in our first quarter. An exciting first quarter at that here in Bloomington. And Sudfeld with all day. A little shake and bake as he crosses the 30. A short pickup. It'll bring up third and long. Torrey Millender with the tackle. Sudfeld's not going to beat you with his legs.
I tell you, he's a little better athlete than people think for a guy 6'6". Decent, just enough where defensive's got to respect it and defend the read part of their zone game.
Contact made across the line of scrimmage. Millender. Give IU another 5 yards.
Offside. Defense. Number 39. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
Torrey Millender, you're going to see him again. They're trying to show pressure, and they get him with the hard count. That's a veteran quarterback again, and they get the penalty back. Now much more manageable third down. See if they can convert.
Third down and a long four.
They'll run the look offense. They'll see what the defensive set is, and they'll look to the sidelines, even Nate Sudfeld, and get the play from the offensive coordinator.
Sudfeld, as patient as he could be, sends it out of bounds. Nothing doing, and well covered by Southern Illinois. Jefferson Villa out in the flats to make sure that pass didn't have a chance.
And you'll see a great job by the defensive end coming up around the corner.
The punt, 36, Eric Tope. Back, number seven.
You see number 52 coming up. Look, he's in the throwing lane where Nate Sudfeld wanted to throw the ball, and he's just throwing this football away. Didn't want to take the chance of an INT.
Blake Madsen with the quarterback pressure. And fair caught at the 22-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Salukis after the 42-yard punt by Toth. And a reminder, the Buckeyes begin their title defense, looking to avenge last year's only loss in a rematch against the Hokies. It's college football primetime. Number one, Ohio State at Virginia Tech. Make sure you watch Monday at 8 on ESPN and stream live at home and on the go at WatchESPN.com. Now the Hokies stunned the Buckeyes last season at the Horseshoe by 2 touchdowns. Can it happen again?
Well, and Ohio State again. Who's going to be still lining up a quarterback, right?
Yeah, Bama,
it seems
Ohio
to be in
State.
Both these days.
Yeah, it really does. Which should be the final play of a very exciting and eventful first quarter. DeSomer with the carry. He loses two. And it'll be second and 12 for SIU when we come back. 11-7 our score. Second quarter action coming up next. back in Bloomington. 11-7 our score. SIU with its eyes on the upset, a four-point advantage here against Indiana. And the Salukis a season ago, Dave, 6-6, but they lost five of their last six contests. So they started the year hot, couldn't close. A chance for Dale Lennon's squad to be a little bit better, and so far so good.
Yeah, I think turnovers and mistakes were a big part of that stretch of the season. They think they've grown from that, and it starts with their quarterback, Mark Iannotti. And he's playing lights out right now, making great decisions with the ball pre-snap and post-snap in the run game and the pass game.
Second and 12, gain of 9, the tackle made by Crawford. Iannotti once again right up the gut with real estate into Indiana territory and finally dragged down to the 40-yard line. A late flag on the field, the stop made by Crawford after a pickup of 30 yards. SIU so physical at the point of attack with its offensive line.
Oh, they're running inside zone and gap schemes, and it's either quarterback or running back with the ball. That time it came off a fake of the fly sweep. Quarterback counter right up the gut.
The end of the play, personal foul, offense, number 56, 15-yard penalty, first down.
It's a starting center, Garrett Clark, a transfer from Southern Miss, a senior out of Jacksonville. And you can't have this if you're trying to pull off an upset.
And you'll see, it's just quarterback power off a fly sweep, and it's hard to see where the penalty is, but you see Mark Iannotti runs a little bit like a linebacker too, huh? I like it.
So that'll slice that 30-yard gain in half. DeSomer back in at quarterback in the Wildcat package. I thought we were going to see him a good bit here, and so far we have. Straight ahead and back into IU territory. Daquan Isom. Marcus Oliver getting more snaps coming off of a torn ACL against Missouri last season. Tigray Scales out of this one. He's got to come up big this afternoon. And you see the last couple of possessions, a 65-yard drive, a block punt, a touchdown, and a three and out. DeSomer for the first down.
Seven, DeSomer over here.
Current drive already into Indiana territory. Southern Illinois in business, Dave.
Yeah, they're putting plays together, attacking the whole field, being physical at the line of scrimmage. We'll see if Indiana can create some pressure and a loss of yardage on first down.
Keep in mind, Hoosiers are missing four key defensive players. And Prakas out in the flats makes a man miss and crosses the 35. A tackle made by Mangieri. Very impressed with the Salukis offense and how they're keeping IU off balance.
Yeah, Lampracus last time just went in motion. He became the bubble guy. Wide receivers block on perimeter, accurate throw by the quarterback. And it's, you know, 5-6 yards on first down.
Lampracus, one of the lone veterans on this SIU offense after a gain of 6. And Iannotti needed 4. They pick up 6. Ball's on the ground. There was a scramble for it right as he came in. And the first turnover of the contest for the Salukis and a big break for Indiana. Andre Brown comes up with the fumble recovery with Marcus Oliver involved. And it'll be 1st and 10 for Indiana when we come back. SIU with a 4-point lead. Hoosiers football when we return.
It's time now to take a look at the school play of the game presented by the School of Education. The Hoosier football team ended the 2014 season on a high note by claiming the old Oaken Bucket for Purdue for the second consecutive year. This game-winning touchdown came from quarterback Xander Diamond in the final minute when he ran into the end zone from 1 yard out to give the Hoosiers the 23-16 victory. The School of Education, for those who dare to teach.
Hoosier fans, let's dig in and show your IU pride in official team merchandise. Gear up for the season at the Varsity Shop in the Assembly Hall West Lobby. They're also open online 24/7 at iuvshop.com. Go IU! Fans, it's time for some live Mario Kart racing. Welcome to Luigi and Mario here. They have an obstacle course in front of them. And in the winner of today's race will receive a $200 gift certificate from Neil Tire and Auto. Gentlemen, any questions? Are you ready? Cue the music. Ready, set, go! Two wheels, two pedals, one pedal.
Back here in Bloomington, 11-7 our score. David Diaz and Fonte Roy Philpott. And SIU so far trying to pull off this upset. Marcus Oliver forcing his fourth career fumble. Andre Brown, the recovery, just ripped it out of there.
Well, you see Mark Iannotti fighting for extra yards. Again, downfield, love the effort. And really, Marcus Oliver does a great job of raking that football free from Iannotti's side. First true turnover of the game. Obviously, a couple blocks in this game already as well. That one costly for SIU. They were marching down the field.
Yeah, amazing to think as well. Oliver tore his ACL just 11 months ago. Not one of the stars for this IU defense. In and out of the hands of Mitchell Page. AJ Cameron in coverage.
You know, Kevin Johns, offensive coordinator for Indiana, talked to us yesterday going, you know, they felt like they got a little too horizontal last year. A lot of that had to do with Sudfeld being out. But they want to take 2 to 3 shots vertically down the field per quarter. They want to be aggressive. They've got a great quarterback. They're trying to develop their skill outside, and they want to create explosive plays.
Beautiful ball fake by Sudfeld. And the dump off to his tight end. Nice move, and he plows his way all the way down towards the 50-yard line. Pissarro with the reception and a pickup of 19 yards. Tackle made by Kenny James.
That's an area of strength. You're going to see 88 on the left side of your screen. Again, he's going to be the shallow crosser against the fake. Nice job of Nate Sudfeld getting the ball right away, running after the catch.
Jordan Howard on first down, the transfer from UAB. And a pickup of 1 yard. The tackle made by Jackson. Indiana's been able to move the ball at times so far today. But not yet fully in rhythm, trying to find that tempo, Dave. Devine Redding back in the game. And another shot for the IU offense. Sudfeld threads the needle. Cobbs the reception, and good enough for another IU first down.
Yeah, you'll see Simi Cobbs. He's 6'4". He's a guy that can high point the football. Watch him go back. The ball just a little bit behind him. He's going to snag it.
And here comes the tempo. Redding right side. Gain of 8 yards on first down. Ryan Neal the tackle. These tempo offenses in this new age of college football, they can find that rhythm so quickly. And the same play yields a first down on second and short. James with a stop, but not before Redding picked up first down yardage.
Good good hard running by Devine Redding. That's knowing down and distance, making sure you put your shoulder pads down and pick up the first down.
Approaching 10 minutes to play in our first half. Howard runs to daylight inside the five and plows his way for the Indiana touchdown. A 23-yard scoring scamper, and IU back out in front, and a big play right there, Dave.
This is just how they scored on their first possession, but this time it's Jordan Howard. You're going to see the offensive lineman pulling a kick-out block, getting to the second level, and Jordan Howard does the rest, carrying SIU defenders into the end zone.
He just outran Marquise Jackson, reaches Pater. And a big-time answer by this IU offense. And the extra point is up. It is good. Our new score with 10:26 remaining in the first half here in Bloomington. Jordan Howard, a 23-yard touchdown, and the Hoosiers in business.
ESPN College Football, brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
Now the pageantry of college football after a nine-month hiatus, finally back. And 14-11 our score here in Bloomington. Our second lead change after a five-play, 61-yard drive.
You know, it's just as we're looking at Jordan Howard on the sideline, the transfer rule. I'm kind of for it. You see quarterbacks, but now we have a running back coming out and transferring, and now he's in on the, you know, go-ahead touchdown here. I kind of like what it's given a player some flexibility because of change that maybe he's not a part of, or he's graduated, give a guy an opportunity to continue his career somewhere else.
Check that seven-play, 71-yard drive in just over 2 minutes, and so far he's proven to be the real deal. And it's not just Howard, Devine Redding. Nasty 1-2 punch in this IU backfield.
Hey, hats off that offensive line, too. They've been doing a nice job at the point of attack, staying with it. They just got to avoid penalties during the middle of the drive. It's drive killers.
The first and 10 for the Salukis at their own 25-yard line. And another look at Mark Iannotti. 6 of 9 through the air, about 34 yards, Dave. He's done a lot of damage on the ground.
Well, and he's also kicking himself in the tail right now for that fumble. You got to reset and move on and now direct this offense because of you, you're in this game, right? It's 11-17. 11-14.
After just joining us, we saw a block punt return for a touchdown. A fake on the extra point, two-point conversion, a little bit of everything.
59 yards rushing.
Out of the pistol on first down, the handoff. A nice bounce back move by Aaron Stanton.
Hey, Aaron Stanton's only 5'5". When they list you at 5'5", I don't know what your real height is. But I tell you what, you see him bounce off tackles and just kind of hide back there, and then he pops out a little bit.
Gain of 5 yards. You know, Emmitt Smith would always hide behind those big offensive linemen. Nobody could find him, the low center of gravity. Lo and behold, leading rusher in NFL history.
You like those 5'5 running backs, don't you?
They don't hurt my feelings. Straight ahead, a pickup of two. A critical third down coming up.
Yeah, big time third down right here for SIU. And it's where your quarterback's got to come through for you. He's got to manage the situation. The tempo changes on third down. There's a little more sense of urgency. Pre and post snap, very important.
Five-man front shown by the Hoosiers with pressure and wide open. The pass is going to be caught. Adam Feeney off to the races, and there he goes. It doesn't get much easier than that, and you want to talk about coaching. You saw it on display right there. Our third lead change of the afternoon.
Play action. They catch the defense sleeping. They don't keep track of the tight end. You'll see the tight end up here on the right side of your screen, number 87 right there. He just slips right by. No one covers him. He's wide open. Nice job by Mark Iannotti of putting enough air on the ball to make sure he didn't overthrow a wide-open receiver. It's kind of like that fast break layup. It's easy to miss sometimes.
68 yards, and once again, the crowd here in Bloomington absolutely stunned. Extra point is up. It is good. And SIU from the Missouri Valley Football Conference with something to prove today. And so far, in business, 68-yard scoring strike. And the Salukis back out in front. Mark Iannotti all smiles after his career-long touchdown pass, 68 yards to his big tight end, and SIU back out in front.
And you'll see Mark Iannotti, see the guards pull, You see the play action. It looks like that quarterback power they've been running. Linebackers attacking the line of scrimmage, blown coverage, and he puts just enough touch on the ball to make sure he doesn't overthrow the wide open tight end Feeney. And again, that's a great job of quarterback resetting in his mind after the fumble and coming back and leading his team back for a score.
7 of 10 passing, also 59 yards on the ground. Southern Illinois, Dave, with 250 yards of total offense. We're not even halfway through the second quarter.
And you got to be a little concerned if you're Indiana with their defense right now.
Just joining us again, the Hoosiers without four key defensive players in this game. And we still have yet to see one of the top defensive backs here at IU, Chase Dutra. Not to mention the other players that have been suspended. Will not play today in Tigray Scales, Darius Latham, Ralph Green III. It's been an issue.
Hey, and that was blown coverage. I think the free safety had the tight end in that pressure package. And Chase Dutra is a guy that gets guys lined up back there. And boy, when you're playing young guys on the perimeter, you need a veteran presence in the middle of that defensive secondary.
Sudfeld back on the field, handoff. Divine Redding pushes his way across the 30. Gang tackled with T.J. Beelen leading the charge. Gain of 5 yards on first down. Sudfeld, audible. Go zone read, Redding right side. Shoved out of bounds. Marquise Jackson will bring up third down and four, Dave. A gain of 1 yard on the play. And a big third down coming up here for the Hoosiers.
Yeah, you don't want to give that ball back right away to the SIU offense. Need to convert. This is where your quarterback's got to step up. Make a play.
Sudfeld 5 of 8 through the air so far. Powers the pass, and it's nearly picked off on the ricochet.
Pass is incomplete.
Anthony Thompson thought he was going to bring it in, couldn't do it. And too much mustard on that pass.
And they're just running slants on the outside. You see Sudfeld kind of double pumps, throws the ball behind his receiver on the inside slant. And that ball's close to being picked off the tip. Football. Close call right there.
Sidney Cobbs, the intended wide receiver. And Thompson will watch the film of that play tomorrow and think that he should have gotten it.
Hard to tell what receiver is really throwing it to.
DeSomer with a fair catch inside his own 30-yard line after the 41-yard punt. And a reminder, NL Central contenders will clash as the playoff race heats up in Major League Baseball. Andrew McCutchen and the Pirates face off against the Cards and Matt Carpenter. Baseball tonight gets your coverage started at 7 p.m. Then it's Pirates-Cardinals Sunday at 8. Right there on ESPN, and watch ESPN. September rules on ESPN. The Cardinals up 2-0 against those very same Pirates right now. Major League Baseball coming to a close here in the month of September, and college football just getting kick-started. And who knows what we're going to witness here today, perhaps another SIU upset. Iannotti gets to the edge into Indiana territory. And the senior quarterback getting the job done for the Salukis. Keontae Walton finally drags him down.
When you got to account for your quarterback in the run game, you can see safety right there again. Keontae Walton just misfits his run support, and Iannotti shows him just a little quicker than you think, you know?
How bad is Indiana missing Chase Dutra? And out of the flats, down the sidelines. Another chunk yardage play for Billy Reed. Gain of 27 yards, the stop made by Noel Padmore.
Again, they're just going up tempo and attacking the perimeter, getting the ball out quick like that. They like the numbers out on the edge. It's coming out.
You surprised by what you're seeing so far? SIU.
I am a little surprised because I really thought, talking to Brian Noor, defensive coordinator, that this Indiana defense was ready to play. They had a better understanding of the system in year two.
Inati calls his own number back to the 25, a short pickup on first down.
And when talking with Kevin Wilson, too, you know, what's the next step here at Indiana? It's one, be more consistent. Part of that is winning the games you're supposed to win. And they're supposed to win these types of games against the FCS opponent, you know?
And you look at Indiana's schedule, the month of September, very manageable.
Yeah.
A loss to open things up. Not what you're looking for if you're a fan of the Crimson and Cream. Play action. Iannotti gets rid of it. Billy Reed, first down and a late flag, four of them in fact. And a face mask will set up SIU quite nicely, first and goal. And Padmore looked like he grabbed the face mask, Dave, and you just can't do that.
Personal foul, face mask, defense, number 18. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
You see the face mask right there at the end of that play, but that was just Billy Reed off of play action. Padmore, the cornerback, just kind of starts bailing. He's running inside. No safety support in the middle. Wide open throw for Iannotti to make.
Gain of 19 yards plus the penalty. It's first and goal for SIU. And how about Billy Reed, his third reception, doing damage against that inexperienced Indiana secondary. Isom dots the eye straight ahead and stacked up near the goal line. The second effort gets him in. Touchdown, Southern Illinois. Isom, the true freshman, his first career touchdown for SIU.
Hey, listen, SIU, they come out 22 personnel. They're just getting big on them. They get a kickout block, and you see Isom. He's meeting two guys in the hole, gets a little help by the big heavies pushing the pile. But watch him lower his shoulder, fight with the extra effort. And you got to see where the ball crosses the plane right there. That's a touchdown.
Not playing like a true freshman. They're going to take another look at that one to make sure he crossed the
touchdown.
Plane.
Play is under further review.
Now, Isom, just a freshman out of Orlando. They've been very high on what he was able to do in preseason camp. Tell you what, right now, Dave, it's pick your poison between Cameron Walter, Aaron Stanton, and the freshman Isom. SIU's got some weapons.
And none of them are taller than 5'8".
My kind of guys.
Don't tell me they're too short to play the game. These guys are – look, and there was no nonsense right there by SIU. They told you what they were going to do.
Check the right knee. And the left knee make that.
We'll see his left knee right there. Boy, it looks like it's up on top of an IU player. As he rotates, and there's an arm in the way as to where the ball is and his knee. It'll be interesting. Remember, ruled a touchdown on the field. And the replay officials are checking, I'm sure.
There's his knee underneath the helmet of number 44, Marcus Oliver. Well, if you can determine whose knee that is.
Right, that's the question, you know. Remember, indisputable video evidence, you know, to overturn the ruling on the field.
Tom Fielder, our replay official this afternoon. A Big Ten officiating crew talking things over with Dale Lennon.
My point to that play was, is there was no mystery what they're doing, hey. We're lining up on big people.
The runner was down prior to crossing the goal line. It is second down and goal at the half-yard line.
IU's defense given a second chance. Well, you ran that play with success pretty much the entire first half. You got to think you're going right back to it. Either that or your quarterback.
Yeah, they're getting big, or, you know, second down is a great time to play action off after you just pounded it. Their play action has been very effective. Here they are. They're getting heavy with them again. Big personnel in the game.
Play action, Dave. You caught it. And the easy touchdown into the flats. Oh, it doesn't get much easier than that. The great touch. Carmen brings it in. The jumbo package. Well, I know you puts a smile on your face.
Yeah, you know what? They're getting big. They got fullback. They got three tight ends in the game. Again, just a little play action. Lose track of the fullback in the flat.
SIU with its largest lead of the game, 24-14. And the extra point still to come. And the Salukis offense rolling, thank you very much. 319 yards so far, an 11-point lead. Mark Iannotti with the honors. Under 6 minutes to play back in Bloomington. And your eyes do not deceive you. 25-14, the Salukis over the Hoosiers. David Diaz-Infante, Roy Philpott here with you. And that last scoring drive, six plays, 72 yards, Dave, including three of those plays going for 17 or more. So they're getting chunk yards.
They're getting chunk yardage, and their quarterback's managing the football. What I love is how he responded off his fumble. Extra effort, the ball gets stripped. He keeps his cool, comes back, and starts executing the offense again. Making big plays, good decisions with his feet and with his arm.
Iannotti playing like a senior already with 89 rushing yards, a career high in the first game of his senior campaign.
Hey, man, we're talking to him, too, on the phone, asking him about what being benched did for him. He goes, you know, it made me tougher. I had to look at the game from another set of eyes, a new perception, and I came away a better football player.
Inside the five on the kickoff and across the 20 ahead to the 21-yard line. Now the Missouri Valley Football Conference has pulled off its fair share of upsets over the years.
Yeah, and look at one of those teams that's there constantly. North Dakota State got knocked out themselves to get the kickoff this college football season by Montana earlier this year. Look at Northern Iowa and this Youngstown State. This is a physical conference, you know. They're always doing something out there to disrupt the norm.
Three straight national titles by North Dakota State. And who knows, maybe SIU is going to be involved in that mix this year.
They're making a strong statement right here on opening weekend.
Sudfeld back on the field. And this crowd has gone quiet in a hurry. He'll take a shot deep. And it's going to be reeled in. Simi Cobbs into SIU territory on a nice pitch and catch. And the Hoosiers responding once again after a 41-yard pass.
First of all, great protection on that offensive line. You see Sudfeld stand tall from the pocket. great balance, and watch him throw this ball to the back shoulder of Simi Cobbs down the field.
IU goes tempo, handoff Howard left side. And the stop by Cameron.
Tackle by two, Cameron.
Indiana's had time or had success at times moving the football so far in this first half. Still trails by 11. Play action to the dump off. Michael Cooper, first down. First catch of the ball game for the senior tight end out of Texas.
That time Cooper just slid in the backfield from his left H-back position to the flat.
Seven completions now for Sudfeld. Tempo, Howard right side. And a nice pickup on first down.
And that offensive line was just moving the line of scrimmage. They're a zone blocking team. It's a big physical front.
And a timeout going to be called by the Salukis. And David Ellison not liking the feel of this drive for IU.
Yeah, I think he looked out there and saw that last play where that line of scrimmage started to move down the field and thought, better give our guys a blow right now.
Well, if you're Kevin Wilson in that huddle for the Hoosiers, what's he telling his squad right now, Dave, considering they're trailing by 11?
They just got to stay the course. They're in the red zone area right in the front of it, and they've got to find a way to come away with the touchdown. So they've got to execute right now. So you can't have any pre-snap penalties. You got to protect the football and make sure you get a score. You get a score out of this possession.
Now, Nate Sudfeld returning for his senior season. He was lost a year ago. It was a second quarter against Iowa. An injury to his non-throwing shoulder. This is always tough to come back from, and just sandwiched between a pair of Hawkeye defenders. And it's taken him more than 329 days to return.
Yeah, you can see the pain he was in. And he's a guy, and these are the career ranks here in Indiana. And this is only his 15th start. So he's put up some numbers. You know, and I think that's why he has such a sense of urgency coming into this season and this year, because he knows it's precious.
After the SIU timeout, second down and four, out in the flats. There's Jordan Howard. Spins his way inside the 10. First and goal for the Hoosiers. Yard gain. And IU driving once again. Second down and goal coming up after the stop by DeAndre Barnett.
Yeah, DeAndre Barnett just came off that edge, knifing down the line of scrimmage to jump on the running back's back.
First half that has already seen three lead changes. IU trails SIU by 11. Handoff Howard. And the easy 6 points on the scoreboard. And another big answer for the Indiana offense. If you like offense, you've come to the right place.
And you'll see, they're just zoning to the right, and it's a downhill handoff out of the pistol by Howard. And it's a soft edge right there. Look, they're just a safety right there, and he's not going to win that battle at the goal line. Howard's 230, 240 pounds running downhill.
11 carries, 70 yards, two touchdowns for Jordan Howard in his first game here at Indiana. And after the extra point, our new score, 25-21. Southern Illinois with the lead still. Under 4 minutes to play in a very entertaining first half. And of course, with all the big games this weekend, including tonight, Wisconsin and Alabama and Jerry's World, it's a march towards January 11th, Glendale, Arizona, and year two of the college football playoff.
I tell you what, in Phoenix, my hometown, we're getting ready, boy. It's going to be happening.
You got the New Year's Eve semifinal games.
You know, so many people were concerned about how the college football playoff was going to affect the bowl games, and it's going to take away. It was unbelievable. I thought it enhanced everything. And gave him greater meaning to the regular season and the bowl games. I just thought it was phenomenal. Yeah, excited for year two.
Yeah, very big success. And more fireworks to be certain coming up this year. And speaking of fireworks, Jordan Howard rushed for over 1,500 yards last year for the Blazers down in Alabama. And off to a roaring start. Over 6.5 yards per carry so far, Dave. Very impressive for the transfer. And another touchback. First and 10 coming up for the Salukis. By the way, have we figured out what a Saluki is? That was your homework assignment coming into today's game.
Well, since someone whispered in my ear, goes back to the Egyptian time, the pyramids.
Yes, it does.
It's a hunting dog.
Correct. A regal hunting dog.
Regal. Yeah, yes. That's what it said. Very.
You very passed regal. The test.
Not just regal. Very regal.
Very regal. Career high numbers already on the ground for Mark Iannotti, and he has been the story in this first half.
Shoot, he's done it on the ground and through the air. It's really managed the game pretty well. Good decisions. The only mark there was that fumble. That's just because he's fighting for extra yards.
And off the quick pass. And Prakas dances his way close to the 30-yard line. Be a gain of 6 yards. And this is what SIU has done pretty much the entire afternoon, keeping this Indiana defense off balance.
Yeah, quick decisions, attacking the perimeter. You know, quarterback run game, traditional run game.
Now a new quarterback. Get away from the Wildcat package, and coming in for the first time for SIU is McIntosh. Crawford makes the stop. That's good enough for the first down. So we've seen DeSomer, of course Iannotti, and now McIntosh, who they're very high on at SIU.
I understand that, but your quarterback's got the hot hand. You don't bring in a new dealer. I'm on a roll.
I don't think anybody could have said that any better. On first down, McIntosh. Why not? Plows his way ahead to the 44. And Jerry with the tackle. And Jerry, we've called his name a couple of times so far today, but only after big plays for this SIU offense.
Here's a guy that moved from the bandit linebacker position back to probably his more natural defensive end position. The five technique gives him a little athleticism. He's got length. He's a tough football player.
McIntosh dives his way close to first down yardage. Indiana defensively trying to find a way to fill those holes, missing players on all three levels of its defense this afternoon. You see the players being held out.
And it starts to hurt your depth, too. And you're playing an up-tempo offense like you are. Substitution and being able to roll guys in really helps.
Big play here on third and one. Time winding down in our first half. McIntosh. Same play, same result. Needed one, gained two. And that's a first down for the Salukis. Tackle finally made by Andre Brown.
14, Andre Brown Jr. in on the stop.
SIU dominating in terms of time of possession in this first half, and that's got to be driving Kevin Wilson, an offensive coach, crazy.
Well, both teams talked about the strength of their teams was the front seven. That was a big challenge. Could their offensive line hang with the Indiana's front seven?
Iannotti back in at quarterback on first down, the dump off. Feeney scored from 67 yards out earlier, his second catch of the ball game there. Gain of 4 yards with a stop by Shaw.
44, Marcus Oliver, 33, Zach Shaw. Knocked out of bounds.
Under a minute to play. SIU with one timeout remaining. Iannotti with a pump fake, first down. Inside the 35, close to the 30. 14-yard pickup, and the senior quarterback in control so far.
35, Miles Sykes on the stop.
And the short pickup.
19, I am on the
28 seconds and counting remaining.
Well, we talked about how he plays with linebacker mentality. It just that wasn't a big run, but how he finished that run, taking a couple hits on, running behind his pads. I mean, you got to love that.
And this is not a good sign for Indiana. Marcus Oliver tore his ACL a season ago. And playing major snaps today with Tigray Scales not in the game. Down on the turf.
That will really begin to affect their depth at the linebacker position.
By rule, the injury by the defender that's injured results in a 10-second runoff. Southern Illinois has chosen not to use the 10-second runoff.
Ron Snodgrass, our referee today, Big Ten officiating crew.
You see number 44 on the left side of your screen right there. He's making the tit on Iannotti. Boy, kind of hard to see what happened. See those zone read? Iannotti's going to keep the ball. Oh, man, it might have been friendly fire right there. Might have been his own teammate coming in. And bang him, TJ Simmons.
Well, Dave, you played the NFL. You played pro ball for more than a decade. Coming back from a torn ACL, a lot of times there's a big mental hurdle to try to overcome. It's just 11 months ago he suffered that torn ligament.
Yeah, it's amazing what they do now. But you can tell he's limping on that left knee. He's got it braced up. Maybe when he was planting in the ground and took that hit on, a little rotation took place or something. Hopefully that brace will protect it. It's just a little sore.
Ninth play of the drive coming up for SIU. Already with a four-point lead, time winding down in our first half. DeSomer in motion. The wheel route down the field, and it's going to be caught. Josh Scadlin, the backup tight end, makes a reception. Brown with the stop, but not before. It'll be first and goal for SIU.
Again, off the play action, Mark Iannotti, again, under duress, makes a great throw under pressure.
And a smart play. He'll clock the football. 15 seconds remaining. Second down and goal coming up.
Iannotti spikes it.
You'll see Mark Iannotti again fake the fly sweep. He's good. He's got to tuck it. Avoids the rush and the sack. Lays the ball up with great touch to his tight end. Wow.
The 22-yard pickup, and he has been on the money.
That's amazing. The ball distribution within this offense and what Mark Iannotti has done. That becomes very hard to defend.
Reed in motion. And Iannotti will try it himself. Tackled short of the goal line. Salukis have one timeout remaining. And they've yet to utilize it. And finally, time is called with 1 second left. Boy, near disaster
third
there.
And final charge timeout for Southern Illinois.
I think they might have cost themselves a play. It looked like there was about 6 seconds left.
Second timeout.
You know, when you run the ball, you either got to throw a complete, you run it down, you got to get up, either call that timeout right away so you have an opportunity to maybe run one more play.
10 seconds left, yeah.
Boy, they had it. They could have got another playoff. You know, they would have used their timeouts. But they would have had a chance to at least throw the ball in the end zone, either touchdown or incomplete.
All right, so 1 second left. You've got it right outside the 1 yard line. Do you try to reach the end zone or you take the three? And the kicker's not on the field.
I think they're going for it. Yeah. I love this. Why not? The Salukis going for it.
Now the riverboat gambler, Dale Lennon.
Hey, Kevin Wilson sprinting to the numbers.
This will be a 30-second
to get a timeout.
It's a big play. SIU has dominated this first half with already almost 400 yards of offense on the scoreboard and a chance to increase his four-point advantage. Boy, what a game. Dale Lennon in his eighth season with the Salukis. Fans that have made the 236-mile trek have to be very pleased with what they've seen so far, Dave.
I think I'm familiar with that drive.
That's what happens when you fly into Bloomington, Illinois.
Yeah, just a little off. Hey, it was worth it, man. We got a ball game right now.
Indeed we do.
Look, talk about dealing cards. A little blackjack.
Here we go. Third down and goal. Iannotti, left side, touchdown, Salukis.
19, Iannotti, touchdown.
And his big fullback led the charge. Mark Iannotti having a first half for the ages.
Was there any doubt who's going to have the ball in their hands? And you're going to see it. It's off a fly sweep, again, the misdirection, and then it's a quarterback counter. They get a lead blocker by one tight end, a pulling guard, another tight end filling up. They had a hat on a hat.
Everything going SIU's way here in our first two quarters. And this crowd in Bloomington absolutely stunned.
7 Johnson for the extra point.
What will be the final play of our first half? Extra point is up, and it is good.
The kick is good.
53 total points on the scoreboard. If you like offense, boy, you found the right game today. And SIU halfway home to pulling off the shocker for the second time in 9 years. Our halftime score, the Salukis 32, Indiana 21.
And review your rights. The Marching 170 Scott Show is about to begin. A first, a thing every generation will recognize, it's Charlie's Angels, followed by the 1973 detective drama, Barnaby Jones. around all drones and low altitude aircraft. Flying drum major paraphernalia is expected. This is the theme from the Mod Squad, featuring a man who needs no squad, drum major Von Ko. For California Highway Patrol. This 70s TV series convinced a generation that officers on motorcycles cause massive high-speed traffic accidents on a daily basis. Here are the themes from Chips and SWAT. 70 Scots and your marching 100.
Marks the 12th year of competition between Indiana and Purdue in the Governor's Cup. Last year, IU was the stronger of the two schools and won the event for the seventh time. This year, the first competition is on October 7th when the two volleyball teams battle it out at University Gym. That's the first of two meetings between those teams, with each match being worth half a point. That's today's Indiana National Guard Governor's Cup update. Join the Guard today and earn up to 100% college tuition.
Halftime continues here in Bloomington between Indiana and Southern Illinois. And a reminder, the playoff push begins tonight as number 20 Wisconsin takes on third-ranked Alabama. Watch tonight at 8 o'clock on ABC and stream live at home and on the go at watchespn.com. Be right back right after this.